Thanks for tuning in on FairStateBulldogs.com. For Stephanie Dahlman, this is Carly Zerbin. The Fair State men's Division I hockey team is off to one of the best starts in program history. With a record of 8-2 overall, they're ranked 8th in the nation. Our Dominic Koenig is standing by with the head coach of the hockey team.
Thanks, Carly. With head coach Bob Daniels right now. Coach Daniels, obviously successful weekend for you guys. Bowling Green last weekend, a series sweep. Your thoughts on how the team played?
You know, I thought the team played really well, Dom, obviously winning two. I thought in both games we kind of started off slow and we had to rely on Taylor Nelson and net to make some big saves, keep us in the game until we got our legs underneath us. That was more the story Friday night. Then on Saturday night, I thought we started out well and then we relied on Taylor to shut the door. So what we're looking for now to try to string together a little bit better 60 minutes and not rely so much on our goaltending.
Two players on the hockey team noted as CCHA Players of the Week this week, Jordy Johnson, Brett Weiss-Sopel. Your thoughts on their performance?
Certainly, both played very well. Jordy Johnson, it's good to see him have a four-point weekend. We tweaked this line a little bit, put Garrett Thompson on the left wing. Garrett had probably one of his best weekends as a collegiate player, so maybe we found some chemistry with those two and Matt Kersinger. And then for Brett Weiss-Sopel, I'm really happy to see him get it. I think in the past couple years, he's been in the shadow of Zach Redmond and now, to an extent, Chad Billings. But he might be the glue that holds our defensive core together. And he's probably our number one warrior on the team in terms of showing up and competing weekend in and weekend out.
Ferris State 7-0 when scoring first. How crucial is that first goal this weekend?
Well, I didn't know that until you just said I really didn't. So I'm going to have to say it's really crucial. So that's a good stat. Isn't that something? But I did not realize that. So that's good. I think generally most teams, though, if you look, because the games are so close, that the majority of teams that do score first, I would say probably 70, 65% of the time do go on to win.
Lake State undefeated on the road this year as well. Your thoughts on it? You think the Dog Pound is going to be able to bring home a victory for us on the home ice advantage?
Well, I don't know if they're going to do that, but I know they're going to bring a lot of energy to the building. They're going to, you know, help us out. I certainly would rather be playing at home than I would on the road. But even with the student section, you don't know because Lake Superior's got really a great team. And I'm really excited about this week, and it's good that we've got a chance to battle Lake Superior State for first place. It's early in the year, but it still sounds good. It feels good. And I think both teams are beyond the point where we're having a good start to the point where we're having good seasons.
Tim Blasher was obviously suffered a terrible house fire to his home earlier this month. We have a silent auction this weekend. Can you run our fans by that for a quick second?
Sure, yeah, there's a silent auction. Tim's brother, Jeff Blasher, is assistant coach for the Detroit Red Wings. He was able to secure a variety of items, including a replica jersey of Nick Lindstrom, autographed by Nick, some pucks autographed by Zetterberg and Datsuk, a bobblehead of Datsuk, so some four tickets to any Red Wing game but the New Year's Eve game. So there's a lot of really good Red Wing memorabilia plus tickets, and people will have a silent auction, and all the proceeds will go to benefit Tim Blashill and his family.
Coach, thanks for your time and good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Back up to you, girls.
Thanks, Dom. Well, when you're ranked top 10 in the country, it's not surprising when we start to see the Bulldogs chosen for the Player of the Week honor. This week, two Fair State hockey seniors were selected, forward Jordy Johnson and defenseman Brett Weiss-Sopel. Dominic Koenig is standing by.
Thanks, Stephanie. With Jordy Johnson, and now Jordy, great weekend for you, obviously. Player of the Week, your thoughts on being CCHA, one of the best in the league this past week?
Oh, well, it's obviously an honor, but, you know, that week our line was playing good. We had all guys going, and that's really what it boiled down to. You know, my line mates were working hard, and that just carries over to me having a good week.
Lake State undefeated on the road. They're coming in here to your home barn now this weekend. Does that stat give you guys any kind of worry whatsoever?
No, I mean, if anything, it gets you ready. You know, whenever you got a team that's in first, you want to play hard. You want to go out there and win. And so I think we'll be ready to go. And practice has been good this week, and we're looking good.
You guys are 7-0 when scoring the first goal. How important is that?
I mean, that's a crucial stat. Anytime you get out there and you take that wind out of their sails, that's big. And that's obviously our goal going into every game, and hopefully we can do it this weekend.
Jordy, thanks for your time. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Brett Weiss-Sopel, senior defenseman from LaGrange Park, Illinois. Great weekend for you. A goal in each of Friday and Saturday's games last weekend in Bowling Green. Good enough to be CCHA Player of the Week. Your thoughts?
You know, first goal, still blacked out. I don't really know what happened there. Second goal was just a fortunate bounce, squirted out, shot by Graham off the backboard there. Just fortunate enough to pick the corner.
one of the better goals in college hockey. I mean, everyone wants to be humble, but even talking with head coach Bob Daniels in the pregame show on the radio last week, what a pretty goal. And is that credit to maybe, you know, just the patience that you think you might have as a player, as a defenseman here?
Yeah, I think it might have to do with looking pass first, actually. I think I held on looking for the pass there. It kind of just opened up with the goalie biting, so fortunately I hadn't opened that.
Lake State undefeated on the road this year. Does that raise any concern for you guys here in Big Rapids this weekend?
I don't think it raises concern. I mean, it's a really good hockey team. They've only lost one game anyways. And, you know, it's a really, really talented hockey team. It's a team like us that's proven to the league that they belong at the top, and it'll be a fun weekend.
Anything that you think the Bulldogs are going to have to do to walk away with the victory on Friday night?
We're going to have to play our game. Can't start chasing the puck around, playing their game. I got a feeling it might be a defensive battle. We have a smaller surface here, so it's going to have to be hard-nosed hockey to win.
Brett, thanks for your time. Good luck.
Thank you, Dom.
Back up to you, girls.
Brett Weiss-Sopel on a two-game goal streak for the Bulldogs right now. It's going to be a good weekend of college hockey. Both squads come into the series with an overall record of 8-2 on the year. Ferris State undefeated at home with a record of 4-0 in Big Rapids.
The 8th-ranked Bulldogs host the 11th-ranked and first-place Lake Superior State Lakers this Friday and Saturday at 7.05 p.m. If you cannot make the game, catch us on the radio on Bulldog Sports Network or on Flagship Nation 97.3 FM.